Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 2. Welcome back to Dark Souls 2. Yes, more. Okay, so I took a look at the rolling speeds for Dark Souls 2, and I was pretty careful about where I looked, because I wanted to avoid spoilers on anything else. As such, I didn't look at too many sources. It sounds like the original Dark Souls had very discrete percentage ranges, where if you look at your... your percentage weight in the bottom right, there are like certain specific points where you'd hit a different tier of rolling speed. It sounds like that's how it worked. But it sounds like Dark Souls 2 might have a gradient where if you have 1% less weight, you will move like 1% faster. You know, you move... Yeah, it's on a gradient. Possibly. Not quite sure. Either way, obviously, lighter equals better moving speed and faster roll, and yeah. So I'm going to try to get as light as possible. I'm already not wearing pants, but believe it or not, I actually can get lighter than that. Namely, in swapping out my shield. So I almost never use my shield, and if I do use it, I'm going to use it to deflect arrows. So I'm just going to use something tiny. This thing weighs 3. And this thing weighs 0.3. That sounds better. Anything else? 1. Wait a minute. I'm confused. This one seems to weigh less. It looks like it weighs more. It says it weighs 1, whereas this one weighs 0.3. But this one shows my percentage being... Oh, never mind. I was misreading it. 0.5. Okay, well, this thing's a piece of shit. I don't want to go too small. Like, with the transgressor's leather shield, I think at that point I might as well just be holding up a plate to defend myself. However, this seems pretty nice. This large leather shield actually literally looks like a plate. Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna go with this thing. There we go, takes me down to 37%. I really can't ditch anything else. I'm already wearing just leather stuff. Yeah, this shield will be fine. It's fine. It's a pretty good roll, I think. Okay, another thing I noticed, by the way. Oh, yes. Another stat, by the way, that matters. Is adaptability. This one right here. Nope, right there. Raises various attributes to ensure one's survival, boosts agility, and various resistances. The key there is agility. I believe that might give me better running speed, or at least maybe faster response time in terms of raising my shield and doing certain actions. And it's only at 5, so I might want to raise that. I'm not sure. I really wish this game gave you just all this information straight up. Just tell me exactly what it's going to fucking do. It's really frustrating. Raises my agility. It might make me faster at doing some things. It's like, thanks, game. I want to know... I mean, I'm spending my precious souls. I really want to know exactly what it's going to do, and it does not give me that information. Kind of frustrating. Just testing out to see if I can get like a running attack. Hold on. Okay, yeah, so if you're sprinting and you do a normal attack, it does that, which is just like my normal strong attack, except it has 3 swings instead of 2. So if there's a room full of weak enemies, I could potentially run in there and go, "Hi, guys!" Oh, yeah. Show up to the party with a bang. Okay. I got that from the manual, by the way. I was just looking at the various forms of attack. I believe that was one of them. The run-in attack. And yes, I noticed that she, the witch woman, whatever her name is, has brought her wares back to Majula.
It's on the cheap for you.
Jesus, these characters. It's on the cheap for you. Okay, what did you make cheap? I can't afford a damn thing. Do I want any of these things? Don't know if I do. Well, I can't afford them now regardless.
Lively times these are.
See if she has anything to say.
But everyone's so stingy around here. Everyone's so stingy everywhere. You're my only customer. Don't make me beg. Now buy something.
God, she's really desperate.
We call this place Medulla. Not too special, if you ask me. It's just the place where everyone seems to end up. Everyone's so stingy. Everyone's so...
Right. I'm trying to remember where I can go. I know I can go down there to the giant's place, which is probably where I'm gonna have to go. Oh god. I don't know if there's anywhere more to go over here. I feel like there should be, but nothing comes to mind. I'm really not sure. I kinda wanna go back and try to fight the trolls. Or whatever they are, the gigantic hippo things. Let's go give them some payback, huh? Wait a minute. Have I been here? I don't think I've been here. No, this isn't where I came out of. Where is this? Secrets? What is this? Whoa. Whoa. This was here the whole time. Is that a huge sword? What is this? It is a huge sword. Hi.
Have you business with me? The way you're under is all blocked up, you see, by this god-awful statue. Heavens above. Who thought it a good idea to pit it there? Oof, I'm in quite the pickle now. See that statue? Gives me the willies. You stare at it for long enough, it starts to look alive. Ach, it just doesn't seem quite right. There are no craftsmen around these parts. Hey. You don't think a real-life person was turned to stone, do you?
I think that's quite possible.
See that statue? Get... Ach, it... Hey.
Try attacking. You mean this guy? I am not going to attack him. It looks like his sword would murder me, on its own, without him even doing it. I'm pretty sure that sword's sentient. Be wary of message in short left... What? Be wary of message in short left required ahead. What? I have no idea what that means. Left required ahead. Mm-hmm. Enemy ahead. Why, hello there. Oh god, you're gonna come out, aren't you? Yep. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy, you wanna lift up that sword in my, to fight for me? You have a growth. A very disgusting growth. Ew. I think that's his stomach. Longsword. That thing is disgusting. Be wary of poison. It's a big hole in the ceiling, but I don't see anything. Oh, Lloyd's Talisman. Somebody said, like, required on left. So maybe I need Lloyd's Talisman. Let's see what it does. Would I put that as a ring? No. How do I wear a talisman? Oh, blocks Estus recovery within a limited area. Do I need that? What does that even... Like, wouldn't that stop me from drinking Estus, or is it to stop the enemies from drinking Estus? I don't know, that just seems like a bizarre item. I don't know. I'm not gonna worry too much about it. It's quick enough to get back here if I die. Hello. Be wary of poison, indeed. Statue. That's a statue? It's pretty small. Woman or boulder? What? Well, looks like a woman. Who is turned into stone? I see a spirit behind there. I hear a spirit. A statue blocks your way. I'm guessing I hit it. Okay, if that doesn't do it, then... What does? Could try... this. That was moderately ineffective. See, Dory's up there, but I have no way to get up there. Statue blocks your way. How would I unblock you? Hitting you doesn't work. Explosives don't work. So... Woman or boulder? I don't know. Why did that enemy just respawn outside? I just saw its body spawn. Fell to the ground.
See that statue? Gives me the willies. You stare at it for long. Hey.
You stare for long enough and it seems to be alive. Do I just stare at it? I think I'm in a staring contest with a boulder. This doesn't sound like healthy behavior. Hi. I'm patient. I imagine you're patient too. You're made of stone. I don't know. Maybe there's an item. What the? Is that now two bodies that have just spawned on top of each other? Or is that still one? I don't even know what's going on there anymore. Try attacking. Be wary of message in short. Left required ahead. What does that mean? I'm gonna need to use these notes to figure this out, I feel. Is this a new message? Switch, be wary of ambush. And it just spawned outside again. Hold on. Let's keep watching it spawn. There it is! Spawn more. There it is again. Whee! Alright. Well, I could try attacking the guy out there. Maybe I need his sword to break it or something. But I'd rather not. Let me try Lloyd's Talisman. I don't see how that could possibly be effective here, but somebody said left required. And they just picked it up from the left, so... let's give it a go! Well, that wasn't very effective. Actually, let me look at the other weird stuff I've got here. I do some weird things. Rubbish has no value. It's good for nothing. One man's rubbish is another man's riches. For value is in the eye of the beholder. But utility is another matter, and this has none. Okay, so somebody might be interested in it one day. What about this thing? It's a petrified something. Can I use it? Nope, I can't use it. A fresh bloodstain just appeared. My D-pad is still being a piece of crap, as you can see. I'm pressing down, and it keeps pressing right. Can I use it in the inventory? Leave. Does that mean drop on the ground? I'm kind of scared. No, let's not do that. Could banish phantoms. I don't know. I'm just gonna leave. Visions of dwarf. Oddball ahead. Indeed. Rear. I'm gonna need one of these notes to help me solve it. Have any new ones appeared? Are you new? Nope, still the same one. Hold on, I think there might be a new one here. Hurrah for weapon. Be wary of toxic. Not too helpful. I'll come back later and see if there's any new messages. Or if anything comes to mind. For now, let's go fight the gigantic hippo things. I feel like some payback is in order. Just keep checking around here for secrets, too. Raise the sun. That tree is extremely bright. Holy hell. Alright, how did I get to those two gigantic trolls? Those over here, right? Yep. Perhaps I could pull just one. Let's preemptively do that. Nope. The other one heard me. Wow. Jesus. I suppose there's not much point in really killing them. I don't think I'm going to get much for it. There's something up there. Hold on. I see you. A soul. Light sconces with a torch. Yep, I don't have one. He doesn't know I'm here. Now he does. Fucking hell. Usually when you get hit with like a sword or something, you have time to respond. Like you get hurt, but then they kind of wait a little bit. Being all respectful like, giving you time to dodge away. But in that case, when that attack starts happening, if you get hit once, you are fucked. I wonder if I should just try the shield. I remember I could rebound their attacks pretty easily. Yeah, their reach is just extremely far. I don't think the shield's gonna hold up, though. A little bit small. Okay. Yeah. What I tried to do there was use the rebound thing. And once again, I'm completely incapable of doing it. Okay, that didn't work so good, did it? Okay, I don't have the patience to fight those guys. You could do it if you were super patient and you dodged all of their attacks and just ran away until they finally fell down and then took a couple shots at them and then ran away until they fell down, because they're very clumsy. But fuck that. Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure if I can go anywhere at these other locations. I'm trying to think. I fought the boss. I used the key to go to the soldier's rest. That seemed to be a dead end. You know what I'm actually going to try using? My human effigy reverses hollowing. I've never done that, ever. I'm going to do it, just to do it. Humanity restored! I'm beautiful again. Look at my beautiful legs. Alright, so that gives me full health. However, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna become undead when I die, just once, so it's not gonna last too long. It still doesn't feel like I'm rolling far enough. But at least I've got a shit ton of health. Watch, I probably won't even be able to defeat one giant. They don't have any ranged weapons, so I'm just gonna go ahead and take that thing off. Whoa. Oh! I can summon somebody. Sure. Ama. Sure. Summoning failed. The sign has disappeared. Well, pfft. You freaking summon tease. Okay. Sure. Summoning failed. Somebody's already used this. Wonderful. Next. Anyone? Anyone? Okay. Thanks for the help. What about the Blue Covenant? I joined them and that guy said they're supposed to be there whenever you're in danger. I'm in danger now. Help, please. Ooh, there. To get to that, I have to already aggro the giant. Oh. Bonfire on the right. It's right there. But wait a minute, can I activate it? Yeah, I can activate it. Okay. I don't think I can rest at it, but I can activate it. Summon. Yes. Summoning. God damn it. Come. Yes. Sign. Da, fuck you, fucking. Damn it. Useless. They really don't have that much health. Cracked blue eye orb, what does that do? Invades the world of the guilty. Yeah, I'm good. These summons are useless. Useless. Try circling around and then attacking. beautiful. I'm not talking about the sun or anything like that. I'm talking about my legs, of course. I have beautiful legs. Even looks like I shaved, I think. Let's get some more practice. Yeah, okay, they're not too bad. But I'm fighting one. Pretty sure there's a spot up there where I'm gonna be fighting two, maybe more. Oh god. Oh god. Alright, this one has a different movement pattern. Just gotta be patient. They're kind of sublime bone dust, too. They're kind of deliberate in their attacks. Like, they raise it up and you think they're about to come down, but you gotta wait because they're getting ready to strike. They don't quite do it. Weakness, play dead. How do I play dead? I know how to die, but I'm not sure how to fake die. Alright, what was that dust? Burning bonfire to upgrade Estus Flask. Ooh! Hell yes! Just like a shard, I guess? Charred ash and bones, cast them into the far fire in Majula to increase the HP restored with each use of your flask. Wait, but this is not the far fire in Majula. But I can still burn it anyway. Should I go back? They say these are the remains of a saint who cast himself into the bonfire, but we'll never know for sure, for soot and ashes tell no story. Alright, well, just to be really, really safe, let's go burn it back here. Bone dust. Smells like burning bones. I don't even know what burning bones smells like, and oh my god, what are you wearing? Holy shit, look at this guy. That looked fucking amazing. Okay. Can I level up? I don't think I have what it takes to level up. No, it takes 2,000 to level up next. Okay, I don't mind getting more practice on these guys. And farming more souls. I guess this guy disappeared. Another human effigy. Man, look at how big this place is. It's massive. I love the scale in this game. It's amazing. Welp, I win. Thank you for the souls. What the hell? Treasure. Try right and then treasure. What is this thing? Don't know, but I'm bowling it. Isn't that where I fought the boss? So if I pull more of those things, I get a bigger battle arena, allowing me to battle him easier, I think? Or something? Oh, I see a bonfire up there, too. Interesting. Try attacking and then jumping off. Why would I want to do that? Something tells me the person who left that message did not have my best interests at heart. Weakness lightning. I don't exactly have the capability for lightning. Alright, let me see if I can pull one. Oh god, I really don't want to fight three at the same time. Oh, Jesus. Well, the other ones are backing up. This one's not. Let's see if I can get him out here. Okay, cool, cool. I notice he has a very large sword. I think you might be special. Yes, he is. Alright, so they have a bunch of different types of weapons. Oh god, you're coming fast. Oh no. You have a shield. Oh no! And I'm undead again. I should have just fought them inside of there. It's a nice round little battle arena. That didn't last for long. But yeah, it looks like I get to keep my health for now, but I think every time I die, my health will successively go down until it reaches a minimum of half health, and then it seems to stay there, I think. I believe that's how that works. Yeah, 400 souls just for killing one, wow. I'm gonna get a lot of souls here. And I need to go collect my souls, that's the first thing I need to do. Hello, goodbye. You wanna fall off too? That would be lovely if you did that. I should probably spend my souls, huh? Nah, I'll wait till I have enough to get two levels. I'll defeat these guys and then go spend them. Try mimicry. What? Want me to mimic being a stone? Try blocking, but pure luck required ahead. Oh, come on, it's not pure luck. Don't be silly. Yeah, it's like the others are waiting for this guy to finish me off. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna fight him over here. Okay, it was worth it. Now I've only got one to deal with. Oh my god. Clever. Clever, 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 that little jab. I just heard something open up. It's like one of these coming out. But it wasn't this one, obviously, because that was already open. Hmm. Oh, here it is. Another layer? Maybe that's why that boss fight was so hard. Because I hadn't done this. Yep, a little bit bigger. That's so cool. I just love the way Dark Souls is built. I mean, look at that. I'm building up my boss arena. You know, the boss arena is not just one encounter. There's a bunch of stuff leading up to it that allows you to change the environment. I mean, how cool is that? It's freaking awesome. Fine work, indeed. Oh yeah, I was gonna level up, wasn't I? I do have like 4,000 souls. I think I should spend them. Let's go do that. Should have just enough for two levels. Next one costs 2,000, next one after that will probably cost like 2,200 or something. Don't mind farming these dudes for souls, especially when they give me so many. Okay, can I upgrade twice? Yes, I can. I'm not quite sure what I want to upgrade. I think adaptabilities. I probably should do adaptability. Looks like it increases my poise. But what precisely does that do? Ability to withstand the impact of attacks, total value for all equipped armor. I don't really know what that means. The ability to withstand the impact of attacks. And if I can't withstand it, what happens? Stamina's always good. Not sure two stamina is gonna make much of a difference, though. Get more attack. Don't really need more attack. I think I might just put another point in adaptability. Let's try it. Yeah. Should be fine, right? Probably making a horrible mistake. See if I notice any differences. Wait a minute. Can I block with a weapon? Is that what this is? I might actually be able to block with this thing. Holy shit. I should try that. Maybe not on a giant, but I should try that. Actually, maybe I will try it on a giant. I'll try it on you. Come on, attack. It did. It protected me quite a bit. But it... Unfortunately, though, it didn't cause them to, like... I'm not sure what the term would be. It didn't cause them to, like, go back in shock, giving me an opening. But it did certainly absorb the damage. Of course, I'd rather just dodge it. Come on, let's go through this again. Look at this fancy footwork. Yeah, what do you think of that? What do you think of that, huh? 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 Because he didn't like my fancy footwork. Well. I mean, they're surprisingly weak. They really are very, very weak in terms of hit points. But they can do shit tons of damage. Oh yes, they're doing the same thing at pretty much the same time. That's excellent. It's excellent. Yeah, another problem is that they're so huge that trying to stun them with an attack is, well, it just doesn't even happen. So if I just go in there and I do this, like, yeah, I'm gonna fuck them all up, it's not going to affect their attacks. They're just gonna start attacking me while I'm spinning around like an idiot. So I can't really do that. Okay, which way do I go? Down there or up here? There's a bonfire up here in the boss room. Or, I guess it's actually above the boss room. How do I get over there? Let's take a look. Look at that view. This is a sunken city. Look at this. Bottom halves of these towering buildings are just submerged in water. Gorgeous view, indeed. So how do I get up there? It looks like there's no way to get there other than in the boss room. So if I go up to that bonfire, I'm pretty sure that means I'm gonna be stuck with the boss. Like, I can't really leave. Well, no. I mean, I could just teleport to another one. Yeah, it wouldn't be too bad. I'm actually getting kind of okay at this game. Try lever. What lever? Weakness, horse. I don't have a horse. I'm sorry, I didn't buy the $200 Founders Pack that gives me a free mount. It doesn't exist. Try slip up. What? Half these messages don't make any sense whatsoever. Right, well, have I done all the levers? I've done a couple of them. Thing is, if I go in there and I die, my souls are going to be left in the boss room and it's going to be rather difficult to retrieve them. I don't know. Whoops. Didn't mean to do that. It might be all of them. I'm going to try it. I'm going to try to run to the side and go up to the bonfire. Let's go. Oh. Oh. I see. I can't get up there to the bonfire. I guess I can get up to the bonfire after I defeat him. Fail. Is this all I have to do? Is this actually working out really well? It doesn't sound like I'm doing damage, but I actually am. Ow. Life gem? I can probably get two hits off. I think I can. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah, yeah. Come on, you know you want to hit me. You know you want to fucking hit me. Come on, do it, do it. Wow. Ooh, my heart's racing. Dragon Rider's soul. Damn, 14,000 souls. Not that I got 14,000, but that I have 14,000. I guess it gave me around 1,100. Ooh. Okay, serious question for anybody who's played this game. My heart's still beating pretty fast. I can't believe I did them on the second try. Anyway, for anyone who's played this game before and encountered these enemies and, you know, played at least to this point or further, has it been your experience that the bosses are exceptionally easy? That's not to say that that was easy. In terms of Dark Souls difficulty, though, that was actually really easy. Compared to other games, of course, it's quite hard. But again, in terms of Dark Souls difficulty, that seemed quite easy. And it's actually a hell of a lot easier than the time I had fighting a lot of other enemies. So am I crazy, or do the bosses so far seem very easy? I'm assuming it's just these initial bosses that are super easy. And the later ones are probably going to be super difficult. But yeah, I've had a more difficult time with the normal enemies than these bosses so far. Like, this one was horribly hard at the beginning, because, well, I wasn't expecting it. I was poorly equipped, and I hadn't done the levers, so I didn't really have room to move. But, whew, that wasn't too bad. Victory! Praise the sun. Feeling pretty good about myself. Oh, there's somebody over there. I'll go speak to him in a second. I think I need to spend some souls. (laughs) Alright, so once again I'm in a position where I can actually buy that cat ring thing. Which would allow me to go down that hole. I really want to see what's down there. But 14,000 souls, how many levels can I do with that? One, two, three, four, five, six. I can gain six levels with that. I can gain six levels, or I can buy a ring. Spend a couple on adaptability. Strength, dexterity, endurance, and stamina. Maybe I shouldn't be upgrading dexterity and strength. It seems like different weapons are meant for either strength or dexterity. Hold on, let me check. See, are there different weapons that only do strength damage and other weapons that only do dexterity damage? Or do these, like, add together? Because there's physical attack dexterity and physical attack strength, or does it just use whichever one's higher? Like, what does that do? Let me check my weapon. So yeah, it says it requires 20 strength and 14 dexterity, so it needs both.
Bearer of the
I'm not really sure how that works. I really wish Dark Souls explained the stats more, and I kind of wish it had less stats, because this is freaking insane. There's too many. Honestly, there's too many stats. Increase strength and dexterity, endurance. Increase my weapon load. Kind of feel like I should. Yeah, I will. Okay, that looks pretty good. One of these days, I'm gonna buy that ring. Not today. Now, the rest of my stats, I'd like to maybe, or rest of my souls, rather, I'd like to maybe spend on something. Maybe. What do you have? Okay, not gonna be buying a weapon. Pretty sure I picked one of those up at one point, didn't I? Oh, it's a weapon. A weapon used to strike with one's fists. Is it actually viable to go through this entire game while just punching people? That doesn't seem wise. Okay, I really want to compare this to what I'm currently wearing, but I can't. Right, well it weighs 7.7 and its basic protection against attacks is 74. 7.7, 74. 7.7, 74. 7.7, 74. 7.7, 74. 7.7, 74. Nope. No, 7.7, 74. So it actually is a little bit better, although it weighs a little bit more. Okay, what about the hat? This is 16. There's gotta be a way to compare items, right? And I'm just missing it. This is definitely better. I think it might weigh more. I'll try it on. I might regret it.
Thank you.
Actually, no, it only weighs slightly more, and it's actually quite a bit better. Heh. Now I look like a proper zombie. Very refined. Yes, very, very cultured. Very cultured zombie. Wait a minute, do I have a monocle on? I think I have a monocle. Awesome. What's the thingy? I didn't mean to do that. Look up on the very top left of the screen. You see those three green arrows pointing up? I know that's because of the ring I'm wearing. What's the thing to the right of that? Something's been improved. What is that? Do I have something special on? There's something there. It's an up arrow and then something that looks like a snake skin? Hell if I know. Hold on, I've got 2,000 souls.
I knew you'd be around.
How did you die? Did you try to attack the armorsmith? Check the cat. See if there's any little trinkets I can buy. Kitty cat! Can I pet you?
Oh.
Very expensive. Lures certain types of enemies. Smashing it releases traces of souls which attract nearby foes. Does not work on all enemies, but can prove useful in unexpected ways. Curious. Prism stone. The prism stone does nothing special, but if you feel you may lose your way, it can serve as a path marker. Doesn't sound very useful.
Nothing suited you, I presume.
Alright, I'm going back to the giants. Man, all these other people I'm seeing just look fancy, don't they? Awesome shields and awesome armor, and I'm wearing rags. I look like shit. It's a little bit too dark here for comfort. I think I'm gonna light a torch.